and welcome. Today we're going to talk about one of the most iconic artists in electronic music, Jean Michel Jarre. With a career spanning 50 years, Jarre has made a significant impact on the history of music through his sonic experiments and spectacular concerts, and he currently boasts over 80 million records sold. Jean-Michel Jarre was born in Lyon in 1948. He is the son of composer Maurice Jarre, famous for his film music.
Consacré trois fois aux Oscars à Hollywood, Maurice Jarre n'est pas seulement le compositeur du célébrissime thème de Laurence d'Arabie, de David Lean. Il a aussi travaillé avec Visconti, Peter Weir et tant d'autres, acceptant parfaitement les contraintes de cet exercice difficile pour un musicien.
And he is the grandson of the man who invented neither more nor less, the first mixing console. We can say that from an early age, Jean-Michel Jarre was strongly exposed to music. He started playing the piano at the age of 5, had jazz influences from his mother, and is already beginning to experiment and create sounds never heard before.
J'enregistrais, je me souviens, les sons de la rue. J'avais aucune idée de ce que je faisais, c'était plutôt pour m'amuser qu'autre chose. Et un jour, j'ai passé la bande à l'envers, j'ai eu l'impression que c'était des aliens qui me parlaient.
J'avais cette obsession d'essayer de créer un pont entre l'expérimentation et l'avant-garde et la pop.
Later, he studied concrete music with Pierre Schaeffer, pioneer of electronic music. In the 1970s, Jarre began experimenting with synthesizers and tape recorders, creating unique electronic sounds.
Alors que par exemple dans un piano ou dans une guitare, tu as un son bien déterminé, là ici, c'est toi qui crées ton propre son. Alors, je veux dire que tu as comme ça, avec cet instrument-là, tu as 1000 pianos. Une fois, ça sera un son de piano, une fois, ça sera un son de pluie, une fois, un son de brouillard, une fois, un son de locomotive. Je veux dire, mais le rôle du compositeur reste exactement le même.
Jean-Michel Jarre est aussi un hit qui a forever marqué l'histoire de la musique.
Électronique, Oxygène, c'est le titre de cet album.
In 1976, he released his first album, Oxygen, which quickly became a huge commercial success. The album was a real turning point in the history of electronic music. With its mix of pop melodies and atmospheric electronic sounds, the success of Oxygen was followed by several other acclaimed albums, including Equinox and Les Champs Magnétiques. Jarre also continued to experiment with advanced technologies, such as laser and computer graphics, creating concerts that were both visual and sound spectacles. His concerts were often massive events, attracting hundreds of thousands of spectators. In 1986, Jarre had a concert in Houston, Texas, to celebrate the city's 150th anniversary.
Houston Festival 86 is underway. Houston skyline is about to be transformed into a backdrop for the biggest laser light show ever seen in America.
Crews continued working downtown today, setting the stage for Saturday's spectacular show of lights, lasers, fireworks, and music. It's called Rendezvous Houston, City in Concert.
Well, it's being called everything from the show of shows to the biggest concert in history, and officially, it is known as Rendezvous Houston, a laser and light show that's going to use downtown buildings as the stage.
It is horrendous at this point. Both the Katy Freeway and the North Freeway.
The concert attracted over 1.5 million spectators and was listed in the Guinness Book of Records as the largest outdoor concert in history. Jarre has also organized concerts in emblematic places, such as the Place de la Concorde in Paris, at the foot of the Giza Pyramids in Egypt, or even in the Forbidden City in China. Speaking of China, when Deng Xiaoping came to power and succeeded Mao, he wanted to enrich his people and opened the door to Western artists who saw China as a huge market to conquer. However, only one candidate is selected, and you guessed it, it is JMJ, becoming the first Western artist to play in the People's Republic of China after the death of Mao Zedong. The public is won over, as is the great master of electronics, who greatly appreciates China and is very rooted there. He even has a wife, Gong Li, a very famous Chinese actress. Officer of the Legion of Honor, Jean Michel Jarre has been committed throughout his career. Activist for many years on ecological issues.
What's happening in Algeria, in Bosnia, encore aujourd'hui, Rwanda, en Tchétchénie, on s'aperçoit à quel point il est urgent de se mobiliser pour faire descendre la tolérance dans la rue.
He fights in his own way by raising public awareness through spectacular concerts or as here at UNESCO in front of heads of state from around the world. He also collaborated with other artists, but not to compose, but to write, as with François Hardy, Christophe.
Je lui dirai les mots bleus, les mots qu'on dit avec les yeux.
Gérard Lenormand, or even more surprisingly, Patrick Juvé. Over the years, Jarre continued to release new albums and experiment with new technologies, but most importantly, continued with more impressive concerts. More recently, in 2016, he released his album Oxygen 3, a logical follow-up to his original album released 4 years earlier in 1976. In 5 decades, Jean-Michel Jarre has democratized electronic music, and despite his long career, Jarre remains one of the most influential artists of this musical genre. His sonic experiments and spectacular concerts paved the way for a generation of electronic musicians. Ultimately, Jarre proved that electronic music could be both innovative and accessible, and that electronic sounds could be just as emotional and expressive as traditional instruments. Today, Jean-Michel Jarre is not yet ready to retire, and to the delight of his fans, rumors are circulating and will tend to believe that the great master of electronics will soon reappear on stage in China, but this time in the city other than Beijing or Shanghai, around a project bearing the fetish letters O and X, which express the marriage between East and West.
Parce que Jean-Michel Jarre, dans la Chine communiste, c'est un événement historique.
Oui, c'est extraordinaire.